Hey there, my name is Drew Brashler, and in this video, I'm going to be teaching you all about the EQ sections on the Yamaha DM3. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident in your production gear, no matter where you're starting from. Now, if you are on a path of wanting to learn more about audio, I have a weekly newsletter that I put out for free over at audiotoolkit.co. So you can go over there and sign up for free and get a weekly newsletter from me of some of my favorite tips and tricks of the audio industry. Now let's go ahead and dive in and actually see how we get the EQ section working on the Yamaha DM3. Now on the Yamaha DM3, I have my microphone here coming into my channel one. Check, check, check. So we can go ahead and see that I have a good amount of gain here. And if I turn this up, we can go ahead and hear that in our ears. Now our EQ section on the channels gives us a high pass filter and four bands of EQ. So we can go ahead and click this little icon right here to explode this up to a larger screen. Now, once we're here, we have a couple different things that we have to adjust. First things first is we have our high pass filter. Now, a high pass filter is also called a low cut, but on the DM3, we called it a HPF, and it passes all of the high frequency above the point of this filter. So I'm going to go ahead and turn up this microphone here. And if we start bringing this up, we will notice that all of my low end will start going away. And the highest that we can take this high pass filter to is 600 hertz. Now, the point of a high pass filter is to get rid of any low end of a microphone that we don't want to reproduce. So for instance, subwoofer frequencies are below 100 hertz. So if you have a subwoofer and you have a vocal mic that's talking in and that happens to be going into that sub for some reason, anytime you say pee or a popcorn or any plosive words, then there's going to be a large boof from the subwoofer. And one way of counteracting that is by using a high pass filter. We can filter out the subwoofer information that's not actually not useful for this microphone. So for instance, if I'm talking into this microphone, there's no point of me having anything below 100 hertz because there's nothing in my voice that needs to go to a subwoofer. Now, if this was a kick drum, we'd have a different story. We want that subwoofer information going to the sub. We want that low end in that subwoofer. So for a high pass filter for a kick drum, I'd be probably setting it between 20 and 30 hertz, depending on how low that kick drum goes. So for now, I'm just going to set this to about 100. Now, we also have these four bands of EQ. Now we have a low, low mid, high mid, and high. Now our low gives us two different options that we can select from. We can select from a low shelf or a bell-shaped curve. Now a low shelf means that it's going to boost or cut all of the frequencies below this point by the same amount. And so we can see that if I boost by 13 dB, it's going to boost all of the low frequency, especially if I turn off my high pass filter. We can see that it's just a flat shelf going down. Same thing with a cut. If we did this, then it's going to be cutting all the frequencies below this filter point. Now, the benefit of a low shelf like this is I can control the amount of low end that I want from this instrument or vocal. So for instance, if I have my high pass filter turned on and set to 100, and this is just a speech microphone, then what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to set my low point of my low shelf to about 1K. And then I'm just going to go ahead and pull this down by about 3 dB. And so what that's doing is that's reducing all of the frequencies below 1K by 3 dB. Now by doing this, this is actually going to make this microphone brighter. So
check 1, 2. And if I was to turn these off, check 1, 2, there's a little bit amount more low end out of this microphone.
And so then the other thing that we have is bell-shaped curves. Now, bell shape means that I can go and select this low mid, and I can boost or cut, and the bell looks kind of like a bell. And we have this Q adjustment, which is the bandwidth of this bell-shaped curve. So I can go ahead and click that and use my touch and turn knob to make it wider or very narrow. And so if I am doing a wide bandwidth adjustment, that's going to be a tonality change. If I'm doing a very sharp, narrow surgical thing, that's going to be more of something that I would do for a feedback reduction. So say this microphone is feeding back. Well, what I would do is I would grab either the low mid or high mid, and I would go find that frequency. And what we can do is we can actually take this and make it a little bit narrow of a frequency. So we can make it nice and narrow, like 16. And we can raise this up and we can sweep the band until we find that frequency. So say I'm sweeping this and I'm talking into this microphone, and then all of a sudden it feeds back a lot on that frequency that when I'm raising this up, then we can just take this frequency and we can pull it down by however much we need to eliminate that feedback. That's how we can ring out a microphone. So that's what's beneficial for using a very narrow bandwidth adjustment on a bell-shaped curve. Now, if I'm wanting to change the tonality of an instrument, I'm going to be reaching for a mid-size to a larger Q or bandwidth of my bell shape. And so, for instance, I can go ahead and set this Q to be about 2. 2 is a good amount to start with. And so for this vocal microphone that I'm just talking into, there is always this spot around 600 hertz right here that I really don't like in vocal mics. So what I'll do is I'll just go find that 600 and I'll just pull it out by about 3 dB. And so we have a 3 dB reduction on a low shelf below 1K, and we have a 3 dB reduction about 600 hertz on this bell-shaped. Now, we also have our high mid, which is also a bell-shaped curve. And then we have our high band, which when we pull up into this drop-down menu, we can select between a bell-shaped, we can select a high shelf, which is the opposite of a low shelf. So a high shelf is going to boost or cut all the frequencies above that filter frequency by the same amount. Or we can choose a high cut, and we can turn that on. So a high cut is also called a low pass filter, meaning that all the frequencies below this filter point is going to be passed through the filter, and all the high frequency above this point is going to be cut out. And so we can see that this is a high cut or a low pass filter. So another thing about our EQ section is you can have a more advanced user come and set the EQ. And then one tip is if you have a brand new audio engineer, maybe a volunteer, someone who's not used to using EQ as much, one thing that you can do is you can press into this one knob. And then what we have is the ability of just using our touch and turn knob to change the intensity of the EQ, either make it more drastic or more subtle. So we can see that I have this EQ curve, and I can take this intensity knob and I can raise it up to do a more intense cut, or I can lower it down to flatten it out. Now, this is going to be really useful for those people that are utilizing this in maybe like a kids' room of a church or a smaller venue where you maybe have a volunteer coming in or a brand new audio engineer that doesn't know how to EQ as much. You as an advanced engineer can go in, set some EQ settings for the channels that you have, and then change all of your channels to be on this one knob mode for then be able to just adjust the EQ section with this one knob. So if I was to take this off and go make some pretty drastic adjustments here, and then we go back into my one knob, we can see that if I take this intensity and turn it up, it's going to boost and cut the frequencies more severely than I had before. Or if I lower this down, it's going to make them a lot less intense. Now, the other cool thing in this is that there is a vocal adjustment. So I'm going to set our one knob vocal mode to OK. And then on this single knob, we can take our microphone and we can talk into this and we can start adjusting this up. And as we see, our adjustments on this microphone are being made as we're raising and lowering this microphone. Check 1, 2, check 1, 2, check 1, 2. So again, if this is in a room with a new audio engineer that's not used to EQing, you can set this on a vocal mode if it's a vocal microphone that they're adjusting, or you can set it on your own mode that you have, set your advanced EQ settings, and then change it into this one knob mode and have those audio engineers be able to adjust it. Now, there's another thing that I want to talk about before we finish out this section on EQ, and that is in our stereo left right And our mix buses, we have the ability of having a 31-band EQ on top of the channel EQ. So I have my stereo left-right selected here, and we have a 4-band parametric EQ that we have on the channels. And we can notice that our low, we got rid of our high-pass filter. So if we needed to access that, we could go and drop down on our low band and see that we have a low cut here. But if we select into this next mode right here, we have the ability of making 15 adjustments on a 31-band EQ. And so the 31-band EQ goes and separates out into third octave increments across the band from 20 hertz all the way up to 20 kilohertz. Now this is useful if you are needing to ring out a speaker. So for instance, if you had a floor wedge in front of you and you were wanting to get this microphone not feeding back as much into that floor wedge, what you could do is you could go and select into your mix and then go and adjust our 31-band EQ and have 15 adjustments on this bus. Now, so we can actually hear this, I'm going to do it on my stereo left, right. And so for instance, I'm going to go and find 1K and I'm just going to go ahead and boost this up. And we can hear that there's a very large boost now on this, and then we could go ahead and cut it out. Now, this is one way of making multiple bands of adjustment on our speaker outputs for our mixes or our main left, right. Now, if we want to, we can actually go ahead and hit fader assign, which will then flip our faders into adjusting these bands. And so we can now see that here is my 1K adjustment, and so I could boost or cut up to 15 dB of either direction. And if I was wanting to go and get to a different frequency, I can just go swipe, and we can see that these are changing. So now this is going to adjust the 200 hertz. Check, check, check. Check, check, check. Now, utilizing the channel EQ and the output EQ for your main left, right, or your mixes, or just the channels into making a good mix for yourself, you have a lot of different options available to you on the Yamaha DM3. Now, I hope this video was helpful for you. If you do happen to have any questions, or there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on the DM3, or really any of the production equipment that's out there, please post that in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.